Hi there, need to edit a drop-down list in Excel? Let me help. Hey, I'm Sharyn from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you save time, work smarter, and improve your Microsoft Office skills. Right, I'm going to show you how to find the list items, update and remove items, and how to add items to the drop-down list. If you're using an older version of Excel, be sure to watch right to the end and I'll show you a wee extra step you will need to add so that you can easily locate and update an Excel drop-down list from another sheet. And if you love learning new things about Excel, don't forget to like and subscribe. Right, let's get going. Right, let's have a look at how to edit a drop-down list in Excel. So the first thing you'll need to do is click onto the cell that holds the drop-down list. And in this case, you can see it's on cell B3. Now, one of the trickiest things about editing an Excel list is finding where the list belongs. So this is how you can do it. On the Data tab, come across to Data Validation. Now, once you're in there, if you're on a cell that has a drop-down list on it already, you will see the source information or the source location for the list. And in this case, it's saying that this list, the drop-down list, is coming from the Sales Team tab, A2 through to A13. I'm just going to come out of here. Now, sometimes you'll see that information, but you won't see the tab down here. And that's normally because somebody has hidden the tab. So in this instance, it would look like this. So even though you can see it, I'll just come across to here. Here, you may not be able to see the tab down here. I'll just come out of here. So what I'd ask you to do is right click any tab down the bottom here, go to unhide, and you'll see the worksheet name in here. Click on to OK. Now, if the worksheet has been protected, you may not be able to get to it. But if it hasn't been protected, you'll be in there straight away. Now, that's a nice and easy way to find a list. However, sometimes you may come across something like this. So I'm just coming across to this worksheet and data, validation, and you see something like this. That doesn't look like a range, does it? It's actually a named range. So I'm going to come out of here and show you how to work with this. This is a named range called Sales Team. And what I'd need you to do here is I'd want you to come up to this little search box or name box up the top, next to the formula bar. When you click onto the drop-down arrow at the end of the name box, you will see that named range. When you click onto it, it will take you to the list. Now, if at this point you haven't actually gone anywhere, it could be the worksheet that this named range lives in is actually hidden. And if that's the case, what you could do is you could go to the Formulas tab, come across to Name Manager, you will see the named range in here, and it'll actually tell you the worksheet that lives in. If that's the case, then hopefully you can do the same as what I've just shown you by doing a right click, unhide the worksheet, and get to the list. Okay. Now, once you're in here, of course, you can easily go and update information. If I needed to edit Abel's name, I can just overtype it and it'll instantly be updated in the list. So if I go back to the drop-down list over here, you will see that it's now updated. But what if I want to remove or add items to the list? Now, removing's easy. I'm just going to make my way back to the Sales Team list down here. Obviously, all you need to do is delete the entire row. And I would ask you to delete the entire row because otherwise you're going to have a lot of blank spaces in your drop-down menu. So that's easy enough. But what if I wanted to add maybe somebody at the bottom of my list? So I'm just going to come down here and pop another name at the bottom of my list here. Now I'll make my way back to the drop-down list over here and you will see that I don't have that added to my list. And that's because I haven't extended out the range for my list in the data validation box. So what we're going to do is we're going to make our way back to data, over to the data validation box, and you can see that it's stopping on A13. So if I click into the box, and I'm going to extend that out now to 14, so it's obviously including 14 in there, click onto OK, and now you will see that you have your extra item or name in the list. But it's a little different for named ranges. So if I come down to here and you're working with a named range, if I come up to here, data validation, of course that's our sales team there. And when I click onto OK, you'll see that we don't have Xander's name at the bottom here. So it's a little different for a named range drop-down list. To add items to this list, you need to go to the Formulas tab, Name Manager, find the named list and edit it. And in here, you can extend it out. Click onto OK and close out of here. And now you will see that you have that added to your list. So I really hope this instruction has been helpful and you are now able to quickly edit, remove and add to drop-down lists in Excel. And if you use Excel and want to stay connected, please consider liking and subscribing because I'm sharing new videos regularly. And if you know someone who would benefit from this help, please be sure to share this video with them. Hey, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.